God's word will not return void.
Amen.
There's a place where we got to reach where we know it won't return void. Amen. You know, so many times people don't understand where they walk in assumption instead of truth. There's a difference between faith and fear. Faith and fear. One of the things God is trying to bring us to is an arena where, you know, there are such, we are not only in a serious time, in perilous times, and as you can look around the world and see what's going on. If you can't ask somebody, I'm sure they'll tell you. But in this time and seasons that we are, there's so many transitions that are happening. And so many things that are occurring so quickly and so rapidly. We begin to watch God's word unfold in covenant and promises and prophecies unfold. And as they're unfolding, and all of a sudden it seems like there's a delay, and then we wait for the next unfolding. But in between these delays, there's so many things. There's perilous times. You know, where there's perilous times, there's glorious times.
Amen.
Amen. And one of the things that you and I have to get to a place where there is a genuineness. A genuineness. You know, God is looking for genuine faith. Genuine believers. Genuine. Not counterfeit. Not wannabes. But genuine. And in the area of genuine followers, not counterfeit, again, but complete genuine. And unless we're willing to examine ourselves, you don't know whether you're genuine or not. You know, as we were, when I got up here and I began to pray, I saw a sword come in here. And the sword began to cut off heads. And the sword that was cutting off heads, I saw heads flying. Because the Lord said, genuine, genuine does not live out of the head. It lives out of the spirit. And again, we've talked about this before, that God is raising up an army, a headless army. Why is he raising up a headless army? Because to have victory and allow Christ to be the head, you must remove your head. That's what happened to John the Baptist when Jesus showed up. He went in prison, and the next thing that happened to him, he was beheaded. And in this arena, we're living out of the spirit, not by the head. Head is knowledge. Spirit is knowing. There's a knowing. It's spirit to spirit. When you're spirit to spirit with the Holy Spirit, man, because he's the connection to everything. Other than that, people living out of their head. That's why people can't stand. The word says, stand faith. Stand fast in the faith. In the faith. In the faith. Genuine faith. Would you turn to the book of James, please? In chapter 1. Genuine faith. A person that doesn't know their identity cannot walk in genuine faith. If you do not know who you are in Christ, you cannot walk in genuine faith. You're still walking in another realm. You're walking in a hope, which is future faith, but faith that we are talking about right now, genuine, this genuine faith is constant. It's a constant. Everyone say constant. Because when a person doesn't know who they are, they seek to know who they are, and they make decisions to try and find out who they are. They associate with people in the arena and hope that they can find out who they are with them. But the only one that can really tell you who you are is the one who made you. Only the one that created you in connection with him allows you to know who you truly are. In James chapter 1 and verse 2, would you read it with me? Is everybody there? My brethren, do what? Count it what? All joy when you fall into various trials. It doesn't say if. So stop going, why me? When me? That's what it's about. When am I going to go through my trial? Why? Because nobody escapes the trials. You and I live in a fallen world, hard pressed by demonic forces, constantly. The ruler of this earth is Satan. But if you're connected with the eternal, you're connected to one that created you, you have a true ID of who you are, an identity that supersedes all the identity of the world, you are victorious. You are more than a conqueror. No weapon formed against you can prosper. Why? Because you know who you are. And we must reach that place, because until you know who you are, you cannot walk in genuine faith. Amen? In verse 3. Now, so these trials that you and I are going to go through, you're not the only one. Amen? Verse 3. Knowing that this what? Testing of your faith produces what? Patience. This word patience means endurance. So that everything can bounce off of you and you're not going to be affected. You're going to endure no matter what you're going through. You're not a man pleaser, you are a God pleaser. Because you're connected to Him and your eyes are set on Him. Your mind is set on Him. Your heart is set on Him no matter what. Why? When those three are set, you have an ID. Other than that, then you're uncertain of who you really are. And you're still trying to find yourself. Amen? Hallelujah. Let's go a little further. Now, but let, verse 4, but let what? Patience or endurance have its what? Perfect work. So your trials and tribulations are going to perfect you. Amen. Does everybody get this? What, two things that your trials and tribulations expose: your impurities and your enemy. Your impurities and your enemy. But let patience have its perfect work, that you may be what? Perfect and complete, lacking what?
Nothing.
Nothing. Everyone say nothing.
Nothing.
Lacking nothing. Why? So you can get to a place where you don't lack nothing. Why? And even though you may think that you're lacking something, amen? Is everybody with me?
Amen.
You may think that you're lacking something or you're waiting for something, but you know it's coming. Has everybody got it? You know it's what?
Coming.
Everyone say, I know it's coming.
I know it's coming.
That means you're not lacking anything.
Amen.
But let patience have its perfect work, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing. If any of you lacks wisdom, let him ask of God, who gives to all liberally and without reproach, and it will be given. That's something that needs to be asked daily.
Amen.
But let him ask in what? Faith says, when I ask, I have. When I ask, I have. When I ask, I have. Without doubting, for he who doubts is like a wave of the sea driven and tossed by the wind. For let not that man suppose that he will receive anything from the Lord. Why? Because one of the things that moves a person out of position, faith keeps you in position. Fear moves us out of position. Has everybody got it? Fear will move us right out of position. And then what happens is we miss what God's trying to bring us. For let not that man suppose that he will receive anything from the Lord. He is double-minded, unstable in all of his ways. He's allowing fear. So there's moments of time where faith, fear, faith, fear, faith, fear. That's instability. He is double-minded, man, unstable in all of his ways. One day up, one day down. Unstable. Most people who are unstable is because they lean more on how they feel. This is how I feel. This is how I feel. But see, they try to make an excuse and say, this is what I believe, this is what I believe. But in reality, they're believing the feeling. And it misleads them. They make decisions. Emotional decisions are dangerous. Oh, glory. Is everybody okay? Now, faith is constant. It does not waver. Amen? You hear, you see, you do. You hear, you see, you do. It maintains connection with the author and authority, Jesus Christ. Now, if you maintain connection, and you maintain this connection with the Lord, you maintain covenant promises. Why? Because you're going to lack nothing. You know what he promised. You are in position to where you know that you know. In fact, there are times when you don't even ask because you already know. Amen. He says, I know your need. In fact, the word says, seek ye the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And what? All what? All things are what?
Added.
Are what?
Added.
Are what?
Added.
Are what?
Added.
Are added. Hmm. Oh, if we can just live in that place, huh? That's called genuine faith. Unwavered. Unmovable. Not led. Now, in these areas, as we hear and do, we also receive. Why? Because once you do, promises are released. Amen? Genuine is associated with authentic. Real. Bona fide. Sincere. Truthful. Responsive. It's genuine. Genuine. It's pure. Genuine. It's special. Genuine. And one of the things that we're seeing right now is God is testing people's faith. He's checking their character. Why? Because remember, he's always looking for his. 1 Timothy chapter 4. You can't be real unless you know who you are. First Timothy chapter 4. Genuine. It's almost like original, you know? In verse 1, would you read it with me? Now the Spirit expressly says, in a latter time, some will depart from the faith, genuine faith, giving heed to deceiving spirits, easily tossed, and doctrines of demons, easily swayed, speaking lies and hypocrisy, having their own conscience seared with a hot iron, forbidding to marry, and commanding to abstain from foods which God created to be received with thanksgiving by those who believe and know the truth. For every creature of God is good, and nothing is to be refused if it is received with what? Thanksgiving. For it is sanctified by the word of God in prayer. If you instruct the brethren in these things, you will be a good minister of Jesus Christ, nourished in the words of faith and of good doctrine, which you have carefully followed. But reject profane and old wise tales, and exercise yourself towards what? Godliness. For bodily exercise profits little, but godliness is profitable for all things, having promise of life that is now is, and of that which is to come. This is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptance. For to this end we both labor and suffer reproach because we trust in the living God, who is the Savior of all men, especially of those who believe. These things command and do what? Teach. These things command and, listen, many people are falling from genuine faith. We're watching it. We're seeing it. There are people who are proclaiming to be of faith, but they're really not. They're counterfeit. Many are falling. Only those whose eyes are on him are real followers. There's people that are, look at, there's part-time and full-time Christians. And there's temporary followers, and there's part-time followers, and there's full-time followers. Amen? So there are many people who are part-time and full-time. If you are full-time, you are walking in genuine faith. Why? Because you make yourself constantly connected with him no matter what. He is always before you. All your decisions are made with him, not with man. First him, then confirm with man. Amen? Isaiah 26. That's why it takes a personal relationship, doesn't it? If you know him, you know you. Everyone say, if I know him, I know me. If I don't know him, I don't know me. Isaiah 26 and verse 1. Believe me, I run into a lot of individuals that are part-time. Their faith is not genuine. Oh, they got to talk, but they ain't got a full walk. Amen? It's genuine. I mean, it's not genuine. But God is trying to unite genuine faith. Do you realize that five in a room that are genuine faith can destroy more works of the enemy than 20 in a room that are only two of genuine faith? Amen? Genuine faith. Verse 1, would you read it? Isaiah 26. In that day, this song will be sung in the land of Judah. We have a strong city. God will appoint salvation for walls and bulk works. Open the gates that the righteous nation, which keeps the truth, may enter in. You will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on you. Other than that, that person is restless, anxious. Why? Restless, anxious, and oppression are all connected to fear. You will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on you, whose eyes, heart, and mind are set towards the Lord. Because what? He trusts in you. Trust in the Lord forever, for in Yah the Lord is everlasting strength. Does everybody see this? Set his mind on the Lord, perfect, genuine faith. How many of y'all know that genuine faith is peace? There is a rest and a peace. There is no anxiousness because you're carrying the presence of the Lord. 1 Peter chapter 1. We have a teaching, and I encourage you to look it up. It's called Staying Connected. Very powerful. First Peter chapter 1 and verse 3. Genuine faith. The real thing. The real McCoy. Let's speak it together. Blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who according to his abundant mercy has begotten us again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled that does not fade away, reserved in heaven for you, who are kept by the power of God through faith for salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. In this you greatly rejoice, though now for a little while, if need be, you have been grieved by various trials, and they're not done. There's things God is going to allow us to be put into that is going to train us. Amen? Amen. Everything is for training. I don't understand why this is happening in my life. You don't have to. Sometimes you need to just trust your way through. But two things you always want to look for. Lord, what's the impurities in my life? And who's the enemy? Who's my enemies? What's God exposing in my life that are my enemies? So why? Because we're connected to them. They have access to us, so they need to be cut loose from us. Amen? In this you greatly rejoice, though now for a little while, if need be, you have been grieved by various trials, that the genuineness of your what?
Faith,
being much more precious than gold that perishes, though it is tested by fire. Everybody cries for fire, but when a trial comes, they run. Then faith is never established. True, genuine faith cannot be established with runners. Amen. Oh, things he's saying, go my way. Oh, shut up. Amen. Have you no faith? Grumblers and complainers have no faith. Amen. But they carry a bunch of fear. Amen. Oh, it's tested by fire. Everybody cries, fire. Then they're gone. That you may be found to the praise, honor, and glory at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Verse 8, whom having not seen you love, though now you do not, you did not see him, yet believing you rejoice with joy inexpressibly and full of glory, receiving the end of your faith, the salvation of your souls. Listen, when you go home, you don't need faith. Amen? You don't need faith. We're done. When we awake from this realm, we awake in his image. Oh, talk about like-minded. Snap. Glory. So, genuineness of your faith. In other words, you know, it's out of this world. Amen? It's out of this world. It's not of this world, but it's for this world. Amen? Amen. It's out of this world. It's not of this world, but it's for this world, so that man can see and be rescued. So that if you're not on a constant connect, then faith doesn't flow. Faith is obedient. Faith is all trusting. Faith hears, sees, and does. He's a doozer, not a loser. Glory. In this area, so there's a place where you and I must refuse anything that is not pure and according to his will, time in our minds. Why? Fear will always nullify faith. Amen? Fear nullifies. And the enemy's always trying to reconnect you with fear. Did you ever notice when something happens, what's the first? Usually the first things come is worse first thinking. Ah! What does the enemy want you to worst first think first? Try and figure that out later. To put you in fear. If he can connect you to fear, he can access you, steal, kill, and destroy. Has everybody got it? Well, that's why the word says, make no place for the devil. 2 Timothy chapter 1. get sick, you start thinking the worst things. Oh, God, I got this, I got this. I think all of these voices from all hell comes out. Boom, yo, bam, 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 it's the voices from hell. You got this, you got this, you can't do this. Nobody likes you. You're going to die. Hallelujah. See, if you don't have genuine faith, then you fear death. Amen. I'm not saying I'm going to go home today. I'm going to go home. But I look forward to going home. I look forward to leaving this place. That's my hope. I'm not going to ask God how I'm going to. I'm going to trust. You look at the people, there are men and women of God that have known. They knew they were going home. They knew that their departure was that specific day. And they would gather their family together or whatever and say, listen, I'm going home. See ya. They knew when they were going home. Hello? That's being connected, isn't it? Hallelujah. 2 Timothy 1:6. Would you read it with me? Therefore, I what? Remind you to stir up. Everyone say, stir up.
Stir up.
Stir up. When you stir up, you stand up. Amen. You don't stir up sitting down. You don't stir up laying down. You stir up by standing up. Amen. Hallelujah. To what? Therefore, I remind you to stir up the gift of God which is in you through the laying on of my hands. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but power and of love and a sound mind. So when fear comes, it breaks, it nullifies, it severs. Why? Power, love, and sound mind is connected with faith. When power, love, and sound mind are not manifested and expressed, then fear is overtaken. What's the opposite of fear? Faith. What's the opposite of faith? Fear. Fear causes an individual to get in survival mode and fight for themselves, prove themselves. Fear says, I want it and I want it now because this is how I want to live. Well, you're that close to hell. Because only those who do his will enter in. Hello? Verse 8. Therefore, do not be what? Ashamed of the testimony of our Lord, nor of me, his prisoner, but share with me in the sufferings for the gospel according to the power of God, who has saved us and called us with a what? A what? Holy. Holy. That's genuine. That's genuine. That's pure. That's God's presence. A holy calling. Not wicked, not unrighteous, not lustful, not perverse, not deceptive, not counterfeit, but genuine. Who has called us, who has saved us and called us with a holy calling, not according to what? Our works. Not according to what? Our works. But according to his own purpose and grace, which was given to us in Christ Jesus before time began. Read it with me. Verse 10. But now has been revealed by the appearing of our Savior, Jesus Christ, who has abolished death and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel, to which I was appointed a preacher, an apostle, and a teacher of the Gentiles. For this reason, I also do what? Suffer these things. Nevertheless, I am not ashamed, for I know whom I have believed. In other words, I know who I am. and am persuaded that he is able to keep what I have committed to him until that day. Now look at this. Look at verse 13. He says, hold fast the pattern of sound words which you have heard from me in faith and love, which are in Christ Jesus. That good thing which was committed to you, keep by the Holy Spirit who what? Dwells in you. How are you going to do that? Stir yourself up. Once you sense oppression coming, once you sense fear coming, stand up. Amen. And stir up. Amen. Amen? Oh, glory. Now, where fear is allowed, amen, the devil has access to steal, kill, destroy. What's he been stealing from you? What's he been killing in your life? What's he been destroying? Where there's fear, there's defeat. Amen? Where there's genuine faithfulness, there's victory and promises. Is everybody okay? So power, love, and sound mind, when it's nullified, it's because it's nullified by fear, isn't it? But all power, love, and sound mind, when it's it reflects an area of self, because when it's nullified by the power, when it's nullified by fear, then a person is involved in his own power, his own mind, amen, and doesn't carry love, it carries lust. It's nullified. God's love, power, and sound mind is nullified by faith, I mean by fear. Faith is what maintains it. Amen? James chapter 4. Genuine faith. Is everybody okay? Are you getting this? Are you genuine? Don't answer that. Only you know. Amen. Everybody will know by your fruit. Amen. We'll know whether you're genuine or not. James 4, verse 1, what does that say? Where do wars and fights come from among you? Do they not come from your desires for pleasure that war in your members? You lust and do not have. You murder and covet and cannot obtain. You fight in war, yet you do not have because you do not ask. You ask and do not receive because you ask amiss, that you may spend it on your pleasures. Adulterers and adulteresses, do you not know that friendship with the world is enmity with God? Whoever therefore wants to be a friend of the world makes himself an enemy of God. Why? Because he does not walk in faith. Or do you think that the scripture says in vain, the spirit who dwells in us yearns jealously? But he gives more grace, therefore he says, God resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Therefore, submit to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Draw near to God, and he will draw near to you. Cleanse your hearts, your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. Lament and mourn and weep. Let your laughter be turned into mourning and your joy to gloom. Humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and he will what? He will lift you up. More grace. Amen. People want more of God's plan. They want to do more things for God. God ain't going to give it to you. There's a place. He's looking for genuine faith, isn't he? Amen. So in the area of when people say, well, I want more grace, Lord. I want more. I want more and more. He says, so that requires more death to self. More grace, more death. Amen? Everyone say more grace.
More grace.
More death. More life. More submission. More revelation. More humility. I'm going to say that again. More grace, more death. More life, more submission. More revelation, more humility. Romans chapter 8. In verse 1. Hallelujah. You know, not only are we serious times, but some people have some serious issues they need to deal with. And they keep putting them under the rug and hoping that something's going to happen. But many people are not walking in genuine faith, and that hope is not going to happen. Why? Because without cooperation, nothing happens. Amen? Without cooperation, nothing's happening. Why? You're cooperating with God because you have genuine faith. If you're not cooperating, then you're not walking in faith. You're hoping something's going to happen. Hope is future. And you know what happens? Hope is a distance from us that stays constant until you walk in genuine faith, then that hope becomes faith. So that's why people are still hoping, because they're not really walking in genuine faith, and it's distant from them. I'm hoping I can get there. Well, until you start walking in genuine faith, you won't get there. Because hope is future faith. Amen? Faith touches faith. Romans 8, verse 1. Let's speak it. There is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who do not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death. For what the law could not do, in it that it was weak through the flesh, God did by sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh. On account of sin, he condemned sin in the flesh. That the what? Righteous requirement. Everyone say righteous requirement. Of the law might be fulfilled in us who do not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. So if you're walking according to the Spirit, are you walking in genuine faith? Yes. If you're not walking in the Spirit, you're walking in fear. And the enemy's stealing, killing, and destroying. And that's false hope. That the righteous requirement of the law might be fulfilled in us who do not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. According to the flesh is according to the carnal mind, how a person thinks. Has everybody got it? How many of y'all know the enemy's always trying to put stuff here? If this is the way you're walking, then you ain't walking in genuine faith. And you're not going to get anything. Whatever you get, you have to get on your own. God's got a specific plan and purpose for places to you to meet. When you do it, he releases. He's always got things prepared for us because he loves us. You got to remember, everything God's doing, he's trying to get you to the place to receive so that the enemy doesn't steal before you get there. Oh, hallelujah. You ready? Verse 5, for those who live according to the carnal mind of flesh, set their minds on the things of the flesh. You know, it's funny. God says, people make plans, but he laughs. Yeah, go ahead. You got your own will? I get people coming to counsel, tell me what they're going to do. They come in my office for counsel, but they're going to tell me what they're going to do. That's not counsel. You know what I do? Go for it. I don't even counsel them. I just shut up. But those who live according to the Spirit, the what? Things of the Spirit. Has everybody got it? For to be carnally minded is what? Is death. Comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But to be what? Spiritually minded is what? Life and peace. Man, how dumb can we be and still breathe? Until we start monitoring these thoughts, you won't know who's speaking to you. You'll just take everything that it's you. Oh, that must be me. That's not you. You are choosing which one you're going to grab hold of and agree with. Amen? Genuine faith can only be accomplished by being led by the Spirit. Putting yourself last and Him first and everything. Go to verse 12 for a minute. Is anybody there? Let's speak it. Therefore, brethren, we are debtors not to the flesh to live according to the flesh, but if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, these are sons of God. For you did not receive the spirit of bondage again to do what? To fear. But you received the spirit of adoption by we cry out, Abba, Father. The Spirit Himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then what? Heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ, if indeed we suffer with Him, that we may also be glorified together. That's phenomenal. What a promise. What a promise. When you are walking in this faith, you are always going forward. When you are walking in fear, you are going backward. Amen? Acts chapter 10. Fear says, if I don't do this now, I'll miss this moment. If I don't do this now, does everybody get it? If I don't buy this now, I'll never get another chance. Now, there's wisdom behind some of those, amen? If I don't marry this person, another one will never come. Does everybody get it? Then you see the results of it down the road. Then it's like, why? I do that. Fear. Why? 10:34. Hike. Acts 10:34. Are you ready? Let's speak it. Then Peter opened his mouth and said, in truth, I perceive that God shows no partiality. But in every nation, whoever fears Him. Now this is a different fear. Amen. Reverence, honor, and respect. And works righteousness is accepted by Him. The word which God sent to the children of Israel, preaching peace through Jesus Christ, He is Lord of all. That word you know, which was proclaimed throughout all Judea and began from Galilee after the baptism which John preached. How God did what? Anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, who went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. Who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. And we are witnesses of all the things which he did, both in the land of the Jews and in Jerusalem, whom they killed by hanging on the tree. Him God raised up on the third day and showed him openly, not to all the people, but to witnesses chosen before by God, even to us who ate and drank with him after he arose from the dead. And he commanded us to preach to the people and testified that he is he who was ordained by God to be judge of the what? Living and the dead. To him all the prophets witness that through his name whoever believes in him will receive remissions of sins. Very powerful. Hallelujah. Anointing, the eternal presence and power and truth of God Almighty. That's walking in genuine faith. The anointing of God. So see, the enemy's always trying to get us to come out of the presence of God. Walk from underneath that anointing and walk in your own strength. Walk in your own talents. Walk in your own abilities. Amen? We've got to sometimes search out what are we allowing to be stolen from us? Amen? Is everybody okay? Amen. 2 Timothy 2. 2 Timothy chapter 2. Genuineness. Yeah. Always reminds me of that song, Ain't Nothing Like the Real Thing, Baby. Genuineness. Are you real? Are you genuine? Amen? Are you the real thing? Do you have that real genuine faith? Are you walking in truth and righteousness? Are you expressing the kingdom of God? Glory. 2 Timothy chapter 2, is everybody there? In verse 8, let's speak it or sing it. Why don't you? Remember that Jesus Christ, the seed of David, was raised from the dead according to my gospel, for which I suffer trouble as an evildoer, even to the point of chains. But the word of God is not chained. Therefore, I endure all things for the sake of the elect, that they also may obtain the salvation which is in Christ Jesus with eternal glory. This is a faithful saying. If we what? Died with him, we shall also live with him. If we endure, we shall also reign with him. If we deny him, he will also deny us. If we are faithless, he remains faithful. He cannot deny himself. Remind them of these things, charging them before the Lord, not to strive about words to no profit, to the ruin of the hearers. Be diligent to present yourselves approved to God, a worker who does not need to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. But shun profane and idle babblings, for they will increase to more godliness. And their message will spread like cancer. Hymenaeus and Philetus are of this sort, who have strayed concerning the truth, saying that the resurrection has already passed, and they overthrow the faith of some. Nevertheless, the solid foundation of God stands, having this seal. The Lord knows those who are his, and let everyone who names the name of Christ depart from iniquity. But in a great house there are not only vessels of gold and silver, but also of wood and clay, some for honor and some for dishonor. Therefore, if anyone cleanses himself from the latter, he'll be a vessel for honor, sanctified and useful for the master, prepared for every good work. Praise be to God. Let's go to Hebrews chapter 10. Hebrew. Hebrew this morning. But Hebrew tomorrow. Glory! Aren't you glad we're not religious? 10:32. Let's speak it. But recall the former days in which, after you were illuminated, you what? Endured a great struggle with sufferings. You know, after you get to a point where you become dangerous to the enemy, he's coming after you. But God has already given you the victory. If you're truly in position and walking in genuine faith, you will lose no battle. You will be victorious. Verse 33, that takes cooperation, amen? Partly while you were made a spectacle both by reproaches and tribulations, and partly while you became companions of those who were so treated. For you had compassion on me in my chains and joyfully accepted the plundering of your goods, knowing that you have a better and a what? An enduring passion for yourselves where? In heaven. Why? Their eyes were not on the earth. They are not on material. They are not on what I can get. They're on treasures in heaven. Therefore, do not cast away your what? Confidence, which has great reward. For you have need of what? Endurance. So that after you have done the will of God, you may receive the promise. For yet a little while, he who is coming will come and will not tarry. Now, the just shall live by what? What kind of faith is that? Genuine. Genuine. If anyone draws back, my soul has no pleasure in him. But we are not of those who draw back to perdition, but those who believe in the saving of the soul. Philippians 2. Philippians chapter 2. You know, there's something powerful the word says. It says, bad company corrupts genuine faith. Bad company corrupts genuine faith. The Lord says, hang out with those who have a pure heart. Amen? It's amazing. People get phones, they start connecting all of their past. And you know, it's doing corrupting their faith. They connect with everything. Hi. Become soulishly demonized, I guess. Hallelujah. You know, the enemy will use anything to become a stumbling block. What is between you and God now becomes an accursed item. Got real quiet in here. Verse 1. Philippians chapter 2. Therefore, if there's any consolation, let's speak it in Christ. If any comfort of love, if any fellowship of the Spirit, if any affection and mercy, fulfill my joy by being what? Like-minded. Having the same love, being of one accord and one mind. In other words, genuine faith. Let nothing be done through selfish ambitions or conceit, but in lowliness of mind, let each esteem others better than himself. Let each of you look out not only for his own interest, but also for the interests of others. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, did not consider it robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, taking the form of a bondservant and coming in the likeness of a man. And being found in appearance as a man, he did what? He humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even the death of the cross. Therefore, God also has highly exalted him and given him the name which is above every name, that the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, of those in heaven and those on earth and those under the earth, that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. And I want to close in 2 Corinthians 6. 2 Corinthians 6. Verse 14, vitally important. What does it say? Do not be unevenly yoked with unbelievers. Hello. For what fellowship is righteousness with lawlessness? And what communion is light with darkness? And what accord has Christ with Belial? What part has a believer with an unbeliever? And what agreement has the temple of God with idols? For you are the temple of the living God, as God has said. I will dwell in them. I will walk among them. I will be their God, and they shall be my people. If they do what? If they come out from among them and be separate, says the Lord, and do not touch what is unclean, and I'll receive you. I'll be a father to you, and you shall be my sons and daughters, says the Lord Almighty. Therefore, having these what? Promises, beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and the Spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of God. Oh, powerful. Genuine faith. It's time to get real. It's time to be genuine and start busting off that garbage of the fear that comes and puts people in a state of survival instead of surrender, opens the door to the enemy. Your plans should be his plans. Amen? If they're your plans and not his plans, you're out of order. It's plain and simple. And you're always going to reap what you sow. Amen? Praise God. Father, we thank you for your word. We are honored and blessed. Let the seed that's been imparted in each and every one of us here today be protected by the blood of Jesus and grow and bear fruit for your glory. That the heart, mind, and will and the desires and the character of Christ will have dominion in every part of our being so that we would walk in genuineness of faith and of character. that others may see you in us, because we know you. And by knowing you, we know who we are. And to Jesus be all the glory. In Jesus' name.